vortex, the frigid weather pattern explained. Among the terms used to describe winter weather, among the most dreaded is the polar vortex, the ominous sounding term sounds like some earthly black hole trying to kill us with Arctic air. It started appearing in weather forecasts more frequently this decade, especially after polar vortex of 2014 that froze out Chicago Midwest. What is the term polar vortex?
Hearing the term polar vortex a lot. During all of this cold weather, and we've been seeing it on social media, we've been hearing our friends talk about it, but what exactly does it mean, and what's behind it? Our Tommy Clark is here with why this deep chill is happening across Iowa.
Well, Alex, although we've got some miserable temperatures, it's not anything new. Still, it can prove to be dangerous. The polar vortex we're experiencing stems from a large area of low pressure and cold air surrounding both of the Earth's poles. By itself, the danger lies in the magnitude of how cold temperatures get when the polar vortex expands, sending Arctic air south into areas that are not typically that cold. The life-threatening system has had a major impact on us here in Iowa. Lots of schools and universities canceled classes Wednesday, and some won't resume until tomorrow. Businesses told employees to stay home, and thousands of flights were canceled. We've also seen multiple cold deaths across the Midwest, and we could see more of this polar vortex in the future.
There is some speculation from scientists that as Arctic temperatures warm, we will see more of a disruption of that circulation. Now, in the future, could that mean more frequent occurrences of the polar vortex? It is a possibility.
And of course, just a speculation there, but something to be watching for. Good news, though. Riley says it'll still be extremely cold today, but warmer weather is on.
Flash to send chills down your spine. Over the next few days, it's going to be colder in Chicago than Antarctica. No, the world hasn't spun off its axis. But if you live in the U.S., it might feel that way because the polar vortex is coming. But what exactly is a polar vortex? And why is it so bad an issue? And we have the facts. The polar vortex isn't anything new. It's actually always there, hovering high above the Arctic region, whipping along at 150 miles per hour. But sometimes, the polar vortex loses its way. It weakens and loses its tight circle. And when this happens, it takes an irregular shape and starts wandering southward. And today, that means the USA has an unexpected house guest. Scientists generally agree that the polar vortex is shape-shifting and wandering more often in recent years. And many scientists say there may be a connection between global warming and the vortex. Is that when higher temperatures invade the Arctic, the polar vortex is corrupt. It loses its structural integrity, meaning it goes on a chilly roadshow to the south. And this season's vortex visit is expected to paralyze large swaths of the U.S., with temperatures falling fast. Weather.us meteorologist Ryan Mount predicts that a whopping 250 million people in the continental U.S. will experience freezing temperatures by week's end, and 90 million will have to endure conditions below zero. Minneapolis is expecting to reach 54 below, and Chicago may plummet to 60 below. When you consider that your freezer is probably set to 0 degrees Fahrenheit, 60 below is a whole lot of chill. In fact, at 60 degrees below, any exposed skin will get frostbite in just a few minutes. There's almost no humidity in the air, and snow takes on the consistency of sand. Door handles may simply snap at the touch. So for many Americans, it's time to bundle up and get ready for Vortex 2019. Most scientists agree that as our planet's temperatures continue to rise, our planetary systems will continue to fluctuate, meaning the polar vortex won't stop spinning. But as higher temperatures creep north, our friendly neighborhood vortex will keep taking field trips away from the Arctic. So stay warm, bundle up, and give thanks that you don't live even further to the north, because at some point in the next few days, the polar vortex will reform and head back home, leaving all of us to thaw and shovel our way out of its wake.
the USA, this is what causes extreme cold temperatures. Questions. What is the